What we're teaching in this video is completely custom. We'll use Zapier to connect our Instagram feed to a fully custom responsive layout using CSS Grid. Here's what we'll teach. We'll create a collection, a simple database in Webflow. We'll create a Zap. This is what will connect our Instagram account to that collection. We'll design how the photos will display on the screen. We'll test it out. Then for some advanced work, we'll use properties in our style panel to match the branding of an artist who does framed prints. What we're setting up will add new Instagram posts to our grid, to the grid we're building, but it won't grab all the existing posts. Okay, let's start with the collection. This part is fairly straightforward. We already have a page design here for our artist. We built this from scratch, but our goal is to get our Instagram feed to populate this area right here. So all we need to do is go over to CMS and add our collection. We're creating the database. We'll call this collection Instagram feed. And all we need now is an image field. We want our database to be able to show the actual images from Instagram. And we also need nothing else. That's it. Let's save and then let's create the collection. Okay, that's one step down. What's the next step? Zapier. And we have a basic format. When this happens, do this. A trigger event and a result. And it works like this. Let's select Instagram. When new media is posted in our account, this will work for images uploaded to Instagram. We want this zap, this whole process to activate. So we'll connect our account. Greamer, what's your password?
Password.
Your password's password?
Yes.
For Instagram?
Yes. It's my password on the Twitter. It's my password on the Google+.
That's not a thing anymore.
I still got it.
It was discontinued.
My other one is more secure.
Your other password.
You want to know what it is?
Not really.
It's 1234.
Once you connect your account, we can test and continue. And then for the result, we want to connect that first part, this first step to Webflow. We'll make sure the action event works like this. When new media is posted to Instagram, we want to create what's called a live item. After we select that, let's continue so we can select our account. We'll select ours, you should select yours, or as we already know, Greamer's usernames and passwords are essentially public knowledge, so Google him if you haven't already. As for us, we're using this Photo Stories project. That's our site. And once we select that, we want to link it to our collection. We want to link it to the database we created earlier, Instagram feeds. Just a few things left to link here. We want to link the image, the standard resolution URL. This will bring in new images we post to Instagram into this process. We'll set the name to grab the caption text. Now, what do these two things mean here? Archived and draft. Archived and draft, they're referring to what will happen in Webflow. But for now, we'll just set these to no. And once we do that, let's do what we did before, test and continue. And we're ready to activate our zap. And as always, let's verify the zap is switched to the on position. That's part two. Part three, let's build our collection list. And in order to get our Instagram feed to pass along new photos into our grid, let's ask Greamer to take some photos. So here's what a collection list is. It's a list of items from our collection, from that database we created earlier. And when we drag in a collection list, we're grabbing a collection list and dragging it right in, we're placing the collection list. We'll just link it to our Instagram feed collection. And you can see right away, we have an entry in our collection list for every image we've just uploaded to Instagram. Now, depending on your setup with Zapier, images can take some time to show up here. You might want to refresh your project in Webflow if updates aren't showing up right away. Speaking of which, there are no actual images inside each box here. That's okay. We'll cover two ways to do this. Let's start with the quick version. The first thing we can do is drag in an image element. We're just dragging in an image element into any of the items in our collection. And because we dragged it into one, it automatically populated every single item in our list. All we have to do is go in and link our blank placeholder image to the actual Instagram image in our collection. And that's it. If you're okay with these static images like this, you can stop here. If we want to make more of a grid layout, here's how to do that. This is the second option we're going to cover. Let's go into our navigator over here on the left side. We can open and close the navigator at any time over here. And what we'll do is select the collection list, not the wrapper. And we'll change our display setting so we can use CSS grid. We'll select grid. Now that it's a grid, let's go in and edit that grid. We can add columns at any time, or if that's too much, we can delete columns. And we can also adjust the space between, the gap in between columns and rows. We can do this by holding shift and dragging to resize that gap. Okay, that's our grid layout. Now, this second option we're in the middle of doing right here, it might be good as is, but let's take it one step further. Let's make it so when you click the image, things show up in a light box like this. And we'll do this in 60 seconds. Let's delete the image. We'll replace it. Let's instead go in and grab a lightbox element. Let's drag a lightbox from the add panel into any of our collection items. Okay, right now the lightbox is blank. That's expected. We'll click on the image inside the lightbox. Then we'll go over to the element settings panel. Here's the key. We want to get images. We want our lightbox to get its image from our collection. We can do that right here. Under our lightbox settings, we'll get our media, these are the Instagram images, from our collection list. And we'll check link with other lightboxes. We'll show why in just a second. And finally, let's give it a name. Instagram. Done.
That was 46 seconds.
Close enough. Here's the point. If we go into preview mode and we click any of the images inside our grid, the lightbox comes up. And at the bottom, because we linked with other lightboxes, we can navigate. We can choose from all our images. And that's it for this step. Ready to test? Let's test. Greemer is going to take one more photo and upload it to Instagram. And if we check it out, the image is on the production site. And that's it. Now, advanced mode, bonus step. Let's style our grid. This is what gives us superpowers. We can do anything with these images. Want to go in and make them 3D on hover? We can do that. Want them to look like something from an art gallery? That's what we're really here for. So, all we have to do here is put our image inside a frame that we're going to build from scratch. Let's go and drag in what will inevitably be our frame. We'll use a div block to do this part, which we can drag inside the lightbox link. For now, this will be a sibling on the same level as the image. Let's keep things organized. We can call this frame. And before we continue, let's make the image. We want to drag the image element. We want to make it a child of our frame. We want the image inside the frame. And all that's left is styling the frame. And as we learned in AP Physics, a framed picture is made up of the frame itself, the matting, the mounting board, the thing inside, and of course, the glass. We're gonna focus on the frame and the matting. For the frame, let's make sure that div block, the frame, is selected. And for the frame, let's use a border. We'll go down to borders and add a solid border. We can choose the width that works best, and we can preview the result. We can adjust, we can see it right on the canvas. That looks pretty good for now. Let's add some space inside our frame. This will be the mat itself. We can do this by adding padding. Padding is the space inside an element. And we can adjust all sides at once. We can adjust padding on all sides by holding down shift on macOS and dragging. Of course, if you're on Windows, you'll also want to hold down shift while dragging. Now, in terms of layout, we're going to use Flexbox to center the image. Let's set our display setting on the frame to flex. And all we have to do with Flexbox is align and justify the children to the center. Flexbox lets us set the parent element, in this case, the frame. It lets us set the layout properties that control its child elements, like the image. That image, that's the thing inside the frame. And as for the glass, we're skipping that part because all we have left to do is play with shadowing a bit. So we'll make sure our frame is still selected and we'll add a box shadow. We want to add a shadow that adds depth to the frame. And the shadow controls here let us tweak. They let us play with the distance, how far away the shadow is from the frame itself. They let us control how blurry they look. And of course, they let us adjust the size. Size is how big the shadow is compared to the original size of the frame. Here it looks good around maybe -9 pixels. And as for the color, let's leave it at black, but we'll go in and affect opacity. We'll make this a bit lighter by dropping the alpha channel to about 40%. That looks pretty good. Let's adjust the angle a little bit, the angle at which the shadow displays. Okay, now something about shadows. This is pretty good and we could stop here, but because there's this feeling of depth, we could increase the authenticity, the realism of this by adding another shadow, giving it a little more lift. And this shadow is like another layer. We can affect distance, we can affect blur. This one's a bit of a harsher shadow, so a smaller value on that blur. And we can affect size, just a little bit smaller this time. Okay, and as for the angle, this will look good underneath, directly underneath the frame, and we'll leave the color at pure black. That's our box shadow. Now, one last tweak here. This isn't so much styling as it's the layout of our grid, the grid itself. Rows in a grid automatically size themselves. What does that mean? It means if there are different images with different aspect ratios, rows might have different heights based on those images inside. If we want all the frames to be 100% consistent in terms of height, here's how we do that. Let's go in and edit our grid. We know the rows. We know their height is set to auto. So what do? We use fraction units. We want to set each row to 1 FR, one fraction unit. Let's set the two rows we see to 1 FR, but we're going to do something else. Greamer might upload another set of images, and we could need more rows. Fortunately, these extra rows will auto-generate. So we want that automatic row, any rows automatically generated, to be 1 FR as well. The result, each row will be the same height. Now, a quick caveat here, they may not be the same height. That's because the content inside the frame and the image itself, they need to be set, they need to be properly configured to take up the full height. Let's look inside the collection and select the collection item. We want to make sure its height is set to 100%. We want it to take up 100% of the row it's inside. That's the first part. Then let's go deeper and do the same thing in our lightbox link, a height of 100%. Last one, let's set the frame itself to 200%. Except that won't look great because it should be 100%. And that's the grid. Equal height rows, equal height frames. If we go over to tablet view, things might be a little tight. Let's go in and edit our grid. And all we have to do is remove. We just have to delete one of our columns. Now it's three across. And just like we did before, we can hold shift and adjust that gap, the gap between the items in the grid. Let's press escape to stop editing the grid. That looks pretty good. What about mobile landscape? Maybe we want two across. That's just as quick. We'll edit our grid. And when we do, we can delete yet another column. These changes on each view here, they only affect smaller views. So if we go back to desktop view, it's still four across. Tablet, that's three. Mobile landscape, that's two. Patrick Bateman.
That's bone.
Mobile portrait. We can do the same thing one more time and reduce it. We can reduce the number of columns in our grid to one. And if we publish, not only do we have the updated images from our Instagram feed, but we have a fully responsive grid. And when we click into any of the images, the full gallery comes up. We can switch between or click between each of our Instagram photos. So, quick recap. We created a simple collection, a database. We used Zapier to connect Instagram to Webflow. We built a simple collection list. We tested how this whole thing works by uploading a photo to Instagram. And we designed a custom CSS grid-based layout that responds on all devices. And that's using Zapier to connect your Instagram feed to a Webflow site.